You talk to probably those same people you were talking to over the weekend who were in that room. Though they will vote for Donald Trump if he runs again, though they liked him in many ways, they were exhausted by him. They just wanted him to get off the stage. DeSantis doesn't give them that feeling. Again, he fights those fights, but doesn't come with all the drama, the personal drama that Donald Trump came for and is viewed by many Republicans, many conservatives as a good, competent governor of one of the most important states in the country.
Well, and he checks all the boxes too, yeah. Michael. I mean, he was captain of his baseball team at Yale. He went to Harvard Law School. Yep. He fought in Fallujah. He was, you know, he's got the pedigree. And he's somebody that Republicans can support. And again, get the positives, what they consider to be the positives of Trump, but actually move towards somebody that actually has lived the type of life that they used to claim they wanted their politicians to lead.
But more importantly, can win back the White House, can shore up the Senate and the House. Watch for Governor DeSantis to play a role in 2022 as one of those leading Republican figures that a lot of candidates are going to be calling on to come into their state. I think Willie hit all the right points about his governance in Florida. You look at his polling there, it's strong. Mm-hmm. And so the question for national Republicans, you know, whether it's McConnell and McCarthy, is how does that help us? Mm-hmm. Well, that brand will help. And you watch him play a role, and Donald Trump less of a role from candidates asking, hey, could you come into my state and help me win next November?
No Republican will say it up here, but we've all heard it. I've heard it from every Republican on the Hill. I've heard it from, you know, every Republican in the Senate, every Republican in the House that I've talked to. I've heard, they want him gone.
They do.
I heard it yesterday. Oh, yeah.
They've been saying it for the last four years that they want him gone. They didn't know how to get rid of him.
And they thought if they ignored him, everything would be fine, and they lost everything, Willie. And so interesting, I talked to somebody yesterday, high up in the Southern Baptist Church, who saw our discussion, and said the miscalculation that preachers made for 4 years was they could ignore Trump and it would just go away. And they kept hoping it would just go away. And it never went away. And churches got divided. The convention got divided. And you know, now there's QAnon conspiracy theories going around there, craziness going around there. And now they're having to confront it because it wouldn't go away. That's a calculation everybody on the Hill made. But when that guy goes, I forgot who said this a couple of weeks ago, but, you know, if he's on a life raft, like, nobody's going to be going after him. This news about DeSantis is the best news that people like Mitch McConnell have heard.
Yes. Almost every private conversation I've had to Joe ends up there, that they voted for Trump. They would probably vote for him again if he runs in 2024, given the alternatives. But, man, they would love for somebody to fill that void that he's left by stepping off the stage. And at this moment, anyway, it looks like it's Governor Ron DeSantis of Florida. It will be very interesting, Joe, to watch, though, as DeSantis is elevated by the party, whether in public ways or private ways, how Donald Trump takes that news, because he still wants everyone to believe that he is the leader of the party, and he is the moment, that he wants everybody to believe that he's going to run again in 2024, at least have that threat out there. But as DeSantis' name comes up again and again and again among Republicans, it feels like a matter of time before Donald Trump turns on him.
Well, I don't know, but it sure does seem like it's Ron DeSantis' party right now, Mika.
All right.
Do we have any other news?
Yes, a critical vote is set for today on whether to begin a debate.
Go ahead.
On a sweep.
I mean, he owns this place.
All right, come on.
Why don't we just put mission accomplished up at the RNC? Then it's over.
Yeah.
It is over.
How does Trump try and take it back? He's silenced.
It's over.
He's sort of impotent at this point because he can't tweet.
Yeah.
He can't go out on Facebook.
No.
So he can't rally the
troops. He does these emails.
With an email from the desk.
I just love the fact that he's
It's over.
He propped
Joe, are you going to be okay?
Up DeSantis.
He did.
talked about DeSantis being his running mate in 2024. And DeSantis may be calling him and saying, would you be
Nikki
my cabinet
Haley
secretary?
Has been hanging out with that.
Willie, help me here, man.
Would you want Donald Nikki. Trump anywhere near
Willie,
he gave
DeSantis a start.
Enough.
Like, DeSantis wouldn't be here, but for him and all these people are out saying, oh, it's DeSantis' party. But unfortunately for him, it looks like it's DeSantis' party, right?
It's starting to look a lot that way, Joe. Here in June of 2021, we'll see if it holds up.
We really have to keep it together.
We're going to move on to other news.
But it is DeSantis' party.
What else is